to another episode of Beauty and the Bolt, but most importantly, welcome back to the first ever season of Beauty and the Bolt. We are so excited to show you all the things we've been working on, and if you are new here, welcome. We are happy to have you. If you are not new here, I don't know why you came back, but I guess welcome back. We've been working super duper hard for the last couple of months to come up with some fun, creative, tool teaching, open source content, and I really want to show you some highlights. Andrew, can we show them highlights? Yeah, highlights, go, roll ahead. Some new cooler tools and exclusive features like a walkthrough of a Blue Angels FA18. And not only that, but we have two episodes planned each week for the entire season, which is like a Beauty and the Bolt record. I know some of you have complained about our lack of uploading frequency, but hey, we're college students, don't expect perfection. So speaking of not uploading frequently, we have a pretty good excuse, and it ties into an announcement. We are officially a registered 501c3 national nonprofit, which means that we can expand our educational outreach activities into schools and beyond. And it's given us the opportunity to work with some incredible sponsors like the Portville Central School District that let us come into their space, shoot video STEM curriculum for them, and you'll be seeing some of that in a YouTube style coming up futurely in this season. Guys, it's like 3 a.m. So on that note, if you want to sponsor a video or let us use a cool tool for a video, please shoot us an email on our website linked down in the description below. We'll also be launching an awesome Giving Tuesday campaign, which means that Facebook is going to be 100% matching all donations made to Beauty and the Bolt, the 501c3 nonprofit, I had to say it again, on that day. So please keep an eye on our social media for announcements regarding that. All right, enough with me yabbering. Let's get the season started. Oh. I wanted to look at something. Today we're gonna be learning how to use this fabulous Ultimaker 3D printer, which lets you print pretty much anything and is better than MakerBots. Okay, we're anti-sponsoring MakerBots. Save your money, people. Just hate MakerBots. To start, we're gonna need to prepare a file, and we're gonna do that on a computer using a software called Cura. For this tutorial, we're gonna be printing something that I download from Thingiverse, specifically an awesome little Sphinx model. But you're, of course, welcome to use anything you find on Thingiverse, or even better, design something yourself.
Start by downloading whatever files you want from Thingiverse. Go into Downloads, find your new folder, and make sure to extract all. Open up the Cura model. Once it's opened in Cura, make sure to check that it's flat. Set your material, nozzle. Generally recommended is pretty good, and I'd always recommend build plate adhesion. This is the raft below the print. Click Save to File, and put it on the SD card in your computer.
To change your material, you're gonna wanna use this dial and select Material. Click it by pressing the center button. Go to Change and select it. It will now start heating the printhead for material removal.
Click Ready and it'll say to insert new material. To do this, you're gonna wanna take the spool and place it onto the spool holder, making sure that the filament is coming up and around and towards this box. Slide it on, take the end, and insert it into the hole that's right here. Gently push until it catches. You'll see the filament slowly get pushed up through the tube. Click Ready, and that'll speed it up. Wait for the filament to start extruding out of the nozzle, like such, and then click Ready. I'm printing in PLA, so I'm gonna select PLA. And then OK. Perfect, my material is loaded and ready to go. Click Return to get back to the main menu. But before you click Print, you're gonna wanna insert the SD card
that we exported your file onto. So slide your SD card into the slot and push it until you hear a click. Go to print, and it'll say it's reading the card. Scroll through the files on your card until you find what you were looking for. In my case, it says Sphinx, so I'm gonna click it. It'll heat up the nozzle and then it will begin printing the raft. If it looks like things are going badly, then don't be afraid to cancel the print and start it over. Make sure to watch out for layers that are peeling up off the build plate, tangled filament, or anything else that could cause a bad print. If that's the case, be sure to cancel the job and start it over. So as you can see, our print is finished, and there's a couple ways to remove this from the build plate. I have a feeling I'm just gonna be able to pick it up, but if you're nervous about it, go in with a spackling knife and hit the edge of the raft and then slide it under and it will pop right off. So now you can see we've got a Sphinx and it looks great and it's on a raft. And since the Sphinx lives on land, I'm guessing it doesn't need a raft. The raft is there for plate adhesion to let your print stick better to the base, but once it's already printed, you don't need it. So I'm just gonna slowly and gently peel this away. And we have our raft and we have our Sphinx. So here's our final product. It is a gorgeous little Sphinx, and you can, of course, print more things than just Sphinxes with the Ultimakers. You can print anything that you design, but this is a rough overview of how to use this printer.
I'm actually just sitting here like befuddled at how good this is.
Thanks for watching this episode of Beauty and the Bolt. If you liked it, you should give us a big old thumbs up and also click that subscribe button if you haven't already, and maybe even consider buying some of the products we featured in the links down below. While you're down there, links to all the source files that we used are there, as well as our awesome merchandise store where you can deck yourself from head to toe in Beauty and the Bolt swag, including shirts, sweatshirts, and socks, just so we could say head to toe, you know. Well, add hats. Just a reminder, every dollar spent on that store goes to our nonprofit, which means that it's making STEM education more accessible, diverse, and engaging for everybody. Signing off, this is Zyla and Andrew behind the camera from Beauty and the Bolt.